Hello everyone, this is Kiki. Welcome to Futuretech channel. Today we will take a deep dive into the important components of electronic components, capacitors. Whether you are an electronic beginner or an experienced engineer, this is very important to understand the basics of capacitors. Capacitors are one of the three basic electronic components and are generally represented by C+ member. Capacitors are made of two metal plates separated by an insulating material called a dielectric. Metals usually have equal amounts of positive and negative charge particles. And if we connect a power source or a battery to the metal plates of a capacitor, there will be a current flow. Due to the dielectric medium between the plates, electrons will not be able to pass through the capacitor, so they will start to accumulate on the plates. After a certain number of electrons accumulate on the plates, the battery will not have enough energy to push any new electronic components into the plates. The capacitor dielectric contains polar molecules, which means that they can change directions depending on the charge on the two plates. So the molecules are in such a way that more electrons are attracted to the negative plate while repelling more electrons away from the positive plate. So once it is fully charged, if we take out the battery, it will hold the charge for a long time as energy storage. If we shortage the two ends of the capacitor through a load, currently will start to flow through the row. The electrons accumulated from the first plate will start to move to the second plate until the two plates return to electrical neutrality. The basic functions of capacitor is to charge and discharge, and the voltage at both ends cannot change suddenly. The basic property is to pass AC and block DC, pass high frequency and block low frequency. Based on this property, different functions such as bypass, decoupling, energy storage, and coupling are extended. Both bypass and decoupling can be considered as filtering, but bypass capacitors are generally placed at the input end of the signal to filter out the noise content in the input signal, while decoupling capacitors are mainly used at the output end of the signal to filter out the noise content in the output signal. Simply put, filtering is to make the AC components in the DC signal or the high frequency component in the low frequency signal flow to the power ground through the capacitor. General capacitors also have the functions of energy storage, just like a battery, which is constantly charged and discharged. Mainly utilize the characteristic of capacitor so that the AC signal in the circuit is transmitted to the next level while blocking the DC signal. Use the characteristic that the voltage across the capacitor cannot change suddenly to prevent the voltage or currently from being too large at the moment the switch is turned on, which may damage the subsequent circuit. According to whether the capacity is adjustable, they can be divided into fixed capacitors, adjustable capacitors, and semi-adjustable capacitors. The capacity withstand voltage value and material type are usually printed on the capacity. Some capacitors use color coding to identify the capacity, and the corresponding color coding table must be referred to. Please note that for polarized capacitor, be sure to distinguish between positive and negative poles when using them, and do not connect them in reverse. The capacitor can be judged by the length of the lead wire. The longer lead wire is the positive pole of the capacitor, the positive and negative poles can also be identified by the shell markings. Today we introduce the basic concept, functions, types, and identification methods of capacitors. Capacitor plays a vital role in electronic circuits. Understanding their working principles and selection techniques will help us better design and debug circuits. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to get more knowledge and practical skills of electronic components. Thank you for watching. See you next time.